don't know where I heard this quote. I think I want to be me. I never really got a chance to be me. How true is that? Our daily lives are filled with a list of how we should look like, how our romantic relation should be, what job paths we should follow. We are taught just to fit in, to be liked and accepted by others. In fact, a friend joked that none of us ever look like a profile pic on social media. So, how do we get past all this and learn how to be ourselves? That is the focus of this episode. How to be yourself. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on! Most of us are not raised to believe that we are unique or that we have our own unique place in the world. Right from school, we are taught to look alike, dress alike, talk alike, learn by rote, and no points for having individuality. Rather than being taught to ask ourselves who we are in effect trained to listen to others' versions of ourselves. We are brought up in our life as told to us by someone else. Which is why being yourself can feel risky. There are many people in your life who believe that being a certain way and showing a certain image is all that matters. And if you start showing your true self, there is a risk of rejection. Like the Billy Joel song, we all have a face that we hide away forever. However, have you noticed that when you have to hide who you are to be in these relationships, you end up feeling lost, lonely, or worthless because you're telling yourself that who you are is not okay. Julia Cameron says, many of us would have been, or at least might have been done, tried something if we had known who we really were. So how do you find the real you? Most of us have never thought about it too often. We all know who we don't want to be. All of us have cringeworthy moments in our lives when we have been selfish or hurtful or weak. But that's in the past. It doesn't define who you are today. It's easy to not like who you are and base your personality on someone else's because they are awesome or funny or rich. Life is what you make of it, and in living through others' perceptions, you really can't call your life your own. So let's do this. While social media is there to help you connect with like-minded people, the constant comparisons do send us into a spiral of negative thoughts. So, instead of counting your likes, swap it for a week. Swap it by doing things which will move you ahead. Set goals, learn a new skill, work on your dream project, or just listen to some motivational talk. That alone will pump up your self-esteem. No matter what you do or say, you cannot please everyone. People-pleasing has its roots in trying to get people to validate your lovableness. Not happening. Even though rejection is a hard pill to swallow, nothing is more exhausting than cherry-picking everything you do. Let go of the notion that it's your responsibility to make everyone else comfortable. You are responsible only for your own happiness. And no, that doesn't make you selfish. Remember, you can give only that which you have. So if you have no love for yourself, what are you going to give? Usually, we say things that we don't mean because we don't know how to sit with things that make us uncomfortable. This goes hand in hand with trying to please others because you're afraid to rub someone the wrong way. When something comes up that either bothers you or goes against what you believe, allow yourself to live with the discomfort and politely speak your truth. Being true to your values and ethos is the greatest gift you can give yourself. When we are over-analyzing every scenario, all social interactions can be exhausting. Why did I say that? Are they bored with what I'm saying? Think of something funny so that they like me. These are parallel conversations that run in your head. By being present, you can focus on what's actually happening than focusing on assumptions. And you know what assumptions are. They are the fake versions of your story. I was talking to a friend the other day when I realized that the entire conversation was focused on what he had done wrong in the past. It's so easy to go there. we have a ready reckoner of all our so-called misdeeds and none whatsoever for what we did right. Which is why appreciating yourself is actually a very important part of self-love and being yourself. Don't beat yourself up or compare yourself with someone else. Every day, look at 5 things that you can appreciate about yourself. Your kindness, your compassion, your smile. Heck, even the fact that you made the perfect cup of coffee today. I know it's tough, but we have to remind ourselves to focus on our own journey and live the way we want. I know you've heard this, but you've got only one life to live. Make it big. Make it yours. Like the quote says, be yourself. Everyone else is taken. Share this video with people in your life. Most of us are struggling with the same issues. A world filled with beautiful people, strong in their own powers, is a beautiful thing indeed. Spread the light, folks. And if you need help finding your voice, taking a stance, and being yourself, reach out to us. Our personal coaching programs are created to fast-track your success.